You're in front of that that aircraft about to board it in the next little while, and the Prime Minister heading to the G20 first, then on to the COP, where he's already copped a bit of a critique from the British government, Andrew.
He's copping it a COP, eh, Kieran? Well, let's see if that keeps going. I think one of the interesting things here is that Boris Johnson, the UK Prime Minister, has called net zero by 2050 heroic. But there are others criticising not having a 2030 target. And I think you asked the Prime Minister today about this. Alok Sharma is the COP26 president from the British government, saying Australia really needs that. I think Angus Taylor will be copping the brunt of more of this, because for Scott Morrison, it's more of a fly-in, fly-out and give the speech visit. But let's hear Kieran question the PM today.
Boris Johnson's COP president, Alok Sharma, has welcomed your 2050 commitment, but he's called for a more ambitious 2030 NDC. What will you say to him when you get to Glasgow?
We've got a plan for Australia. They've got a plan for the UK. And I welcomed Boris's comments the other day, because Boris actually has a pretty good understanding of the Australian economy. But let's just talk about how well the Australian economy has gone with our emissions reductions to date. I mean, when you compare them to our good friends in Canada and New Zealand, which haven't even cracked double digits yet on emissions reduction, and then, of course, the United States or Japan, we're outperforming all of them.
To sum it up, the PM would rather win an election than cop a bit of criticism on the international stage, and it looks like he's done enough for Boris Johnson, at least. Has he done enough on climate here for Joe Biden? He's really wedged on this issue, Scott Morrison, in a way that he wedged Labor at the last election. The other part of Kieran's question there was, how are you going to go with Emmanuel Macron after dutting him over the subs and with the Chinese representative? And that's something we'll be eagerly looking at in Rome to see if there's any form of discussion or any form of snub there, Kieran.
Andrew, and I'll talk to you from Rome on Sunday morning, Sunday agenda, 8 o'clock Eastern Daylight Time. Make sure you join us, Andrew. We'll be live from Italy for the G20. So we'll catch you then, Andrew. Safe travels.